leading Douglas aviation engineer Ed Heinemann wanted to take a different approach when designing a replacement for the Navy's AD-1 Skyraider warplanes in 1952. In a bold proposal, he decided to replace one of the biggest single-engine fighter bombers ever built with one of the smallest, lightest attack jets to date. Military aviation history shows that sometimes going cheap is the ideal call, and there is no better proof than the fascinating case of the A-4 Skyhawk, one of the most influential warplanes in American history. The Skyhawk's modest but trusty array of features would engrave its place in the canon of aviation annals as the U.S. Navy's workhorse aircraft during the Vietnam War, flown by notable pilots such as Lieutenant Commander John McCain. To this date, the cheap but ubiquitous warplane known as the Tinkertoy Jet is fondly remembered as it valiantly swooped down over the dangerous Vietnamese jungles to deliver American firepower to the most remote enemy entrenchments of the Indochina Peninsula. The Skyhawk was neither extremely fast nor particularly agile or technologically groundbreaking. Still, it was small, versatile, reliable, and almost half its weight were weapons. A cheap replacement. In the early 1950s, aviation engineer Ed Heinemann developed a novel concept for the Douglas Aviation Company. He planned to replace the AD-1 Skyraider with the A-4 Skyhawk to decrease weight and complexity as much as possible, resulting in a combat jet less than 40 feet long and lighter than 5 tons. The tiny plane had a set of small delta wings that amounted to a wingspan that barely reached 26 feet, allowing it to be stored on an aircraft carrier without having foldable wings. This advantage would make the Skyhawk a vital asset for the U.S. Navy, as its small size meant carriers could store more warplanes, and the lack of foldable wings made the aircraft much cheaper. Additionally, the so-called Tinkertoy Jet was designed to achieve an unparalleled short takeoff and landing performance, proving exceptionally useful when it was deployed in 1956. By then, the Navy still used numerous smaller conventional aircraft carriers with restricted deck space. Propelled by a single J-65 turbojet engine with two flanking air intakes, the A-4 Skyhawk was adequately nimble, but not exceptionally fast, with a top speed of around 670 miles per hour, below the speed of sound. To keep the costs in check, the Skyhawks lacked a radar for detecting and engaging enemy fighters, making it less than ideal for dogfighting. Still, it was equipped with heat-seeking Sidewinder missiles and two 20mm cannons for self-defense should the need arise. The aircraft's lackluster dogfighting capabilities were not a problem, as the Skyhawk's job was to crush enemy ground targets into submission. To achieve this task, its three hardpoints could carry a substantial maximum payload of 8 to 10,000 pounds, including nuclear warheads. In short, Heinemann designed a cheap, reliable, ultra-compact warplane, ideal to deploy from U.S. carriers, with the ability to deliver massive amounts of bombs to enemy targets. The Navy and Marines became immediately interested, and they ordered hundreds of them, with production eventually reaching 2,500 in a wide variety of models. The aircraft became so massively popular that during the early 1960s, every U.S. Navy carrier had at least two attack squadrons of Skyhawks on board, with some of them carrying up to four. The Skyhawk was eventually improved into the A-4B variant, with enhanced avionics and the potential for air-to-air refueling via conventional tanker aircraft, or even from one Skyhawk to another. A more modern version then arrived in the form of the radar-equipped A-4C, giving the aircraft remarkable bad weather and night flying capabilities. Feared in Vietnam. The war in Vietnam took a drastic turn on August 2, 1964, as the USS Maddox destroyer was engaged by North Vietnamese torpedo boats in the Gulf of Tonkin, and tensions rose to a whole new level. A couple of days later, the crew aboard Maddox appeared to detect a second attack that would later be revealed to be a technical glitch. The mishap had historical consequences, as President Johnson promptly requested the first American air assault on North Vietnam, targeting their naval bases and an oil depot in Vinh. Spearheading these consequential sorties were the Navy Skyhawks, who rained fire upon North Vietnam in what became the first of more than 7.6 million tons of American bombs dropped on top of Vietnam. the Skyhawks quickly became the bulk of American air-ground might in the war. But in contrast to more modern strikes, where warplanes can remain at high altitudes while dropping guided payloads, Skyhawk pilots had to dive dangerously close to enemy positions to deliver accurate strikes, putting themselves in highly vulnerable circumstances to be shot down, even by small arms fire. In the preliminary strikes at Vinh, two A-4s were downed, taking the life of Lieutenant Richard Sather, while Lieutenant Everett Alvarez Jr. managed to eject from his aircraft and became the first of hundreds of American pilots to withstand years of confinement and torture in North Vietnamese territory. The Skyhawk would remain the spearhead of the Navy as Washington intensified its involvement in Vietnam, flying thousands of ground attack incursions and participating in critical encounters such as the battles of Hue and An Luc. As the newer versions of the Skyhawk were sent to battle, they became even more essential to U.S. operations in the region. The A-4, E, and F featured two additional hardpoints for carrying weapons, making them one of the most heavily armed warplanes in the world when fully loaded. There are more powerful J-52 engines, a Doppler navigation radar, and a targeting computer drastically increase their ability to engage fighters and defend themselves. The introduction of the A-7 Corsairs gradually ousted the A-4 complement on large U.S. carriers. Still, the Skyhawk's shorter takeoff and landing distance ensured that it would not be decommissioned anytime soon. Through the ringer. Early during the war, the A-4s had to engage the faster and more expensive North Vietnamese MiG-17s, highly maneuverable cannon-armed fighters much more suitable for air-to-air combat. In April of 1967, a MiG-17 downed a Skyhawk in a brutal dogfight, confirming its superiority. However, in a surprising twist just a month later, Lieutenant Theodore Swartz was able to bring down a MiG-17 using an unguided Zuni rocket intended for air-to-ground targets. Still, as lethal as they were to North Vietnamese forces, the Skyhawk's armament also offered significant risk to U.S. troops. On July 29th, an electrical surge ignited a Zuni rocket onboard an F-4 Phantom waiting in line for takeoff on USS Forrestal. The rocket exploded the external fuel tanks of a Skyhawk in front of it, spraying jet fuel and debris across the carrier deck in a dramatic firestorm. As firefighters rushed to quell the flames, the fire detonated the 1,000-pound bombs on the Skyhawk, taking 134 lives and destroying an entire squadron's worth of aircraft. One of those lucky enough to escape the catastrophe was a young John McCain, who had been aboard the A-4E next in line to the one that exploded. McCain managed to bail out from his aircraft as it caught fire and was shot across the deck by the bomb's detonation. A few months later, on October 26th, McCain was raiding a power plant in Hanoi on his Skyhawk A-4E when an SA-2 SAM shredded through one of his wings. The lieutenant commander was quickly ejected into Truk Bac Lake in northern Hanoi and was badly injured. He was then captured and had to endure 6 years of torture and captivity. Navy Skyhawks had flown tens of thousands of sorties by the end of the war, and 195 Skyhawks were shot down by the enemy. An assault delivered by Navy Skyhawks in 1973 is reputed to have been the last air attack delivered by U.S. combat aircraft in the Vietnam War. Later years. The tiny Tinkertoy Jet lingered for several more decades in U.S. service. The Marine Corps was hesitant to part with the dependable ground support aircraft, and a new version would be developed. The A-4M model was fitted with more potent engines, extra cannon ammunition, and the hardware to sling early Maverick missiles and laser-guided bombs. The Skyhawk would also prove to be a reliable asset in the Middle East during the Arab-Israeli conflicts, where the small plane helped the Israeli Air Force attain air superiority over the region. Interestingly, the Skyhawks would also become a major headache for the Royal Navy as Argentinian forces used them against British ships during the Falklands War in the early 1980s. The Skyhawk also continued to be a favorite aggressor plane in U.S. Navy training drills, as it displayed similar speed and agility to its chief historical foe, the MiG-17. As such, it became a helpful training tool at the Top Gun School, teaching Phantom and Tomcat aviators how to deal with slower but more agile opponents in combat scenarios. The A-4 embodied qualities of simplicity and cost efficiency that are said to be lacking in modern aircraft design. It was light and easy to handle, while also being highly lethal, without having complex gimmicks that didn't serve its purpose. Considering inflation, today the Pentagon pays up to 13 times more for a warplane equivalent to the Skyhawk. The philosophy boils down to quality over quantity. Still, the Skyhawk proved that you can employ clever aviation design and have both. Thank you for watching our video. What are your thoughts on low-cost aircraft design? Let us know in the comment section below. If you enjoy our content, please share, like, and subscribe. And for more history-inspired stories, check out all of our Dark Documentaries channels. We post new videos every week.